Hi children, how are you all? I hope you all good and safe. Today we are going to continue the lesson. That is very interesting topic, the League of Nations. It is also called as the Society des Nations. What is the meaning of that? Why it was started? That is we need to know. Actually, end of the World War I. So 1918, this was established. This was established by the victorious nation, particularly two important persons. They were known as the country of USA and then the England. So these are the two countries were given importance to make this League of Nations. In this session, we are going to study what is the objective, what are the structures, what are the organs it possesses, what are the activities it done to the world, and how it led to the Second World War. These are the one we are going to study in this session. Okay, first, structure and composition of the League of Nations. I told you this is established after the World War I. It was established exactly the month of January 10th, 1920. And who established particularly the person? Here you can see the picture, Mr. Woodrow Wilson, President of USA. He was the forerunner of this League of Nations, and it consists of a number of organs. We have eye, nose, everything. So like that, this is also having a number of organs, that is namely the Assembly, the Council, the Secretariat, the International Court of Justice. It is also called as the Permanent Court of Justice and International Labour Organizations. So these are the organs it possesses, and we will discuss one by one. First, the Assembly. The General Assembly, it was established in the place of Geneva. Here you can see the picture. This is an assembly place. In this place, they had two official languages, that is namely French and the English. It is also known as the Victorious Nations language. And after that, in this League of Nations assembly, all the member nations, they have a representation. So each person have an one vote. So that is very, very important. It will discuss all the problems of the world, and they created a number of policies, and everything they discussed, and they took a decision anonymously, which means that is all together. So most of the people should give the acknowledgement to pass the act. So at that time only it can be changed or it can pass any kind of rules and regulations. So that is only known as anonymous. This is about the General Assembly. And after that, the council. So council, it is permanent one. So it is having a number of persons, that is particularly the victorious nations. They are known as here FIB, FIB, France, Italy, Britain, Japan and USA. So these are the persons were called as the permanent members of the League of Nations. And later 1933, the Germany was joined, and after that Russia joined. They also became the member of the League of Nations, but after that they started to quit from the League of Nations. And here, so one vote, already I told you that one vote they had, and the decision will be taken anonymously. And the Secretariat. So Secretariat, it is very, very essential one. Why? Because it started to secure all the records of the League of Nations. And then the Secretary, he is located in the place of Switzerland, so particularly in Geneva. The first secretary of the Secretariat is known as Mr. Sir Eric Drummond. He belongs to England. So he is a man who played a very important role for the Secretariat. And after that, the members of the Secretariat, how they appointed. The staff of the Secretariat, they were appointed by the person secretary, with the consultation of the council. Why? Because the council is the very, very important one, because it consists of permanent members. So secretary and then council, both the persons, they will discuss and they appointed the people of Secretariat. And after that, the Permanent Court of the Justice. It was established in the year of 1922 and it was ended in the year of 1946. It shows that when the League of Nations end. So it was established 1920 until 1946, it worked. So after the Second World War also, it worked for a year. Then only it was disclosed Why? Because the introduction of the UNO. Okay, so the Permanent Court of Justice, it is located in the place of Netherlands, particularly the Hague. So it was located here, and after it consists of 15 judges. And how many cases it handled, and how many cases it gave a suggestion, opinion, and decision, we need to know. Here it handled 29 cases and it gave the suggestions. And after that, 27 separate advisory opinion. Apart from the cases, it gave a number of advice to the member nations. So it shows that a number of work which is done by the Permanent Court of Justice. The International Labour Organization, this is the first important organization, was established in the year of 1919 itself. We know that 1920 only the League of Nations was established, but the International Labour Organization was established before that, 1919 itself. And here it has a separate secretariat and then separate general conferences. So each member nations, they have to send 4 representatives from this organ. So that only they will discuss all kind of actions, they given a number of rights and everything, only because of the International Labour Organizations. Okay, just quick recap about the organs of the League of Nations. So structure. So first one is, we discuss the Central Assembly. So each country one vote, we know that, and then it met in Geneva, but one time it will meet, at least one time it need to meet. And then it had to be anonymous. The decision will take as an anonymous. And second one is the council. The council met many times when there is an emergency. If there is any emergency, at that time it should meet. And then it has 5 permanent members, and later it changed. And after that, each have the veto power. Veto means a negative vote. If I am not agree with the decision of League of Nations, I can use my power, that is known as veto. So against the decision, that is known as veto. Apart from that, I can come out from the League of Nations also, that is known as a veto. So veto is nothing but a negative vote. So that is the one. And after that, the Permanent Court of International Justice, it is located in The Hague, we know that. And then it settled all kind of disputes through the negotiations, that is we need to know. And after that, the secretariat. So secretariat, it records it all the civil records particularly. So we know that the first secretary of the secretariat is known as Sir Eric Drummond from the place of England. Okay, and now we are going to the objective of the League of Nations. What is the purpose of League of Nations was established? We need to know. Actually, only 2 main reasons for the establishment of League of Nations. That is known as to make an peace and to prevent a war. So these are the 2 very important policies for the League of Nations. That is the main objective. And after that, it gave a number of importance also. That is known as foreign policy. So international cooperation in economic and social affairs. It created a number of relations through the economic. So that is the one. And after that, resolve the disputes. So what is the meaning of disputes? A disputes is nothing but a problem. So problem between the member nations. The problem was solved by the people of League of Nations. That is also main objective of the League of Nations. And after that, it had in some lag. What is the lag? So very powerful nation, 3 powerful nations, they were not member of the League of Nations, unfortunately. So that is a great drawback of the League of Nations. Which are the countries? The countries like USA, Germany, and Russia. While we discussing about the criticism of the Treaty of Versailles, the Woodrow Wilson, President of USA, he did not become as a member of the League of Nations. So USA is not a member of League of Nations, and Germany, it was the country defeated by the victorious nation in the World War I. So it is also not in the member of League of Nations. And after that, Russia, it quit from the First World War, according to the Treaty of Brest-Litovsk. So these 3 countries, they were not member of the League of Nations, and it shows that the weakness of the League of Nations. And after that, in the year of 1926 only, the Germany became as the member of League of Nations, and followed by the people of Russia in the year of 1934. And the Germany is a main cause for First World War, at the same time Second World War also. Why? Because in the year of 1933, Germany came out from the League of Nations, and after that 1939, Russia came out from the League of Nations, and it became as the great problem for the League of Nations. And here the activities, now we are going to discuss. So activities, what are the actions which is done by the League of Nations? It worked very long period, but from 1920 to 25, it worked very effectively, and it solved many problems. Particularly three important problems was solved by the League of Nations. So the first problem between the people of Sweden and Finland. Here the Sweden, the country, both the countries, Sweden and Finland, they fought the name of capturing one place. The place is called nothing but Åland. That is an island. So between these two people only there was a problem to capturing the Åland, to showing their sovereignty. So at that time League of Nations entered in that, and it solved the problem of the Sweden and Finland, and shows that the Åland island should be go for the Finland people. So that is the judgment was given by the League of Nations. So first problem, and after that followed by there's a problem between the Germany and the Poland for the purpose of capturing one place, that is known as Silesia. So Silesia, to capturing this place only, there was a fight between Germany and Poland. This problem also was solved by the people of League of Nations. So this is second one. And after that, the third problem, that is nothing but between Greece and Bulgaria. So the Greece attacked the people of Bulgaria. When hear this message by the people of League of Nations, they said that to stop the war. And after that, they appointed committee and they discussed who did the mistakes. So they come to know that the Greece people only, they made a mistake. So the League of Nations said the people of Greece, they need to give in reparations. So the amount penalty should be given by the Greece to the people of Bulgaria. So these three problems was solved by the League of Nations. And after that 1925, they signed one treaty, the treaty called Locarno Treaty. So this is also called as the Western countries in Europe. So these are the countries they signed. Which are the countries? They are known as FIB: France, Britain, Italy, Greece and Bulgaria. So these are the countries they were signed, that is known as Treaty of Locarno. According to this treaty, the member nation of League of Nations, they should not produce any kind of weapons. It is also known as disarmament treaty. So the member nations, they should not produce any weapons. That is the treaty. These are the countries were signed. But this treaty, it led to the problem of the dissolve of the League of Nations. Why? Because the League of Nations members, they are not ready to accept this, and they started to produce a number of weapons. Then automatically they started to quit from the League of Nations, and it became as the one of the reason for failure of League of Nations. We will discuss after that. So violations, the member nations of the League of Nations, they violated. They are the people who established for the purpose of making a peace and prevented war, but these people only violated. So it created huge problem in the world. So what are the violations did by the member nations? So first one, I told you, the commission to hold a disarmament. So disarmament treaty, Locarno treaty was established, but this is not followed by the people of the member nation of League, and it led to the problem. Particularly the leader of Germany, Mr. Adolf Hitler, supposed he asked the League of Nations to produce a weapon equal to the France. But what was happened? League of Nations, they are not ready to give the permission. Then what happened? the Germany quit from the League of Nations in the year of 1933, and after that a number of nations also start to come out from the League of Nations. It is the very important reason for the Second World War. And here, so Hitler, he withdrew in the year of 1933, and after that Manchuria. While we are discussing about the Asia, particularly China and Japan, so Manchuria is a part which is belongs to China. It was captured by the people of Japan, but after that it was revoked by the people of the China. But in the year of 1931, again the Japanese people, they attacked the place of Manchuria. This is against the actions of the League of Nations. At that time, League of Nations stopped this action, but the Japan people, they are not ready to listen it. So they also start to came out from the League of Nations in the year of 1931. And after that, the third country, that is Italy. Italy, they attacked the place of Ethiopia. We know that Ethiopia, it is located in Africa. So the people of Italy, they attacked Ethiopia. It is against the prime objective of the League of Nations. So Italy also came out from the League of Nations. So these three countries, Germany, Japan and Italy, these three countries, they were became as the one team, and they started one axis, that is known as Rome, Berlin, Tokyo axis. We need to know what is the meaning of Rome, Berlin, Tokyo. Actually, Rome is the capital of Italy, Berlin, that is capital of Germany, Tokyo is the capital of Japan. So these three countries, they became as one team, and they started to become as the dictatorship countries. They became the threatened to the world, and they are the main reason for the Second World War. So this is the one of the very important reason for the failure of League of Nations. And after that, the passive witness. After the quit of these three countries, the League of Nations became as worthless. It could not act very effectively, and it became as passive, and it created a number of problems. Why? Because after that also, there is a number of problems raised in the place of Rhineland, Austria, Czechoslovakia and Poland. But at that time, the people of League of Nations, they could not open their mouth and they could not solve the problems. And it led to a number of reasons for the failure of League of Nations. This is also very important reason for violation of League of Nations. And in the year of 1939, the people of Russia, they tried to capture a part of Finland. But the people of League of Nations, they started to raise the voice against the Russia action. And what was happened? Russia also came out from the League of Nations. You need to know that in the year of 1939, they conducted one meeting against the Russia. That is the last meeting was conducted by the people of League of Nations. Okay, we completed the violations of the members. And now we have moved on to causes for failure. Students, you have to give a focus for this topic. Why? Because this is a very important 5 mark for you. So causes for failure of League of Nations. We know that the member nations, they started to become violated one, and they start to quit from the League of Nations, and it led to a number of problems. Apart from that, here also we have a number of reasons. The first reason, that is known as the victorious nations, they are the people who established this, but they gave an importance only for them only. But the League of Nations had a membership worldwide, but they gave an importance only for their own countries. It shows that the European superiority is established in the place of League of Nations. So it has become as the reason for League of Nations failure. And second one is the unanimity of members. According to the 1925 Locarno Treaty, the member nations should not produce any kind of weapons. So the members, they don't have weapons. If anybody attacking their country, they should be depend on the League of Nations permission. Unfortunately, many nations, they are not ready to depend on the League of Nations. They started to quit from the League of Nations. This is also another reason for failure of League of Nations. And third one is no military power. The League of Nations, it didn't have any kind of military powers, permanent. Unfortunately, they had a military only by the victorious nation like Britain, France, and then Italy. These are the countries, they only send an army when there is a need of a military. It shows that the League of Nations doesn't have any kind of the military. It is also become as the reason for failure. And after that, a collective security. The European people, they started to underestimate the principle of League of Nations. And then the people of League of Nations, they started to follow the nationalism, which means they wanted to show that my country should be in superior, I want to be in first, like that. So it has a collective security, but it could not establish in the place of world. So it is also one of the reason for failure of League of Nations. And after that, the dictatorship. I told you, the year of 1939, the three countries, Germany, Italy and Japan, they were joined together and they formed a league that is known as Rome-Berlin-Tokyo Axis. And after that only, they started to reason for the Second World War. So dictatorship has become as the most important reason for the failure of League of Nations. And after that, Wilson, the president of USA, Mr. Woodrow Wilson, he is a man who reasoned for establishment of League of Nations. But what was happened? The person not convinced his country to become as the a member of League of Nations. So it shows that the country or a building is standing without a deep foundation. Okay students, I hope you learned a lot today. We have to recap what are the topics we discussed today. So we discussed the League of Nations, how it was established and what are the structures. That is also we discussed. We discussed all the organs, and after that the objective of the League of Nations we discussed, and we discussed at the same time the activities and violations. At last we discussed the failure of the League of Nations also. I hope you enjoyed very lot. Thank you.